Hey everyone out there, I haven't seen this one yet on YouTube, so I'm going to give it a shot. This is for educational purposes only. Hot Girl Bummer by Black Bear. And essentially we're going to go over what it sounds like using FL Studio. I'm using FL Studio 20 and I'm using Kontakt for the guitar section. And stock plugin for the bass and Trap Boom Essentials for the synthesized lead. So here we go. Educational side of FL Studio. So if you're a beginner, this is going to be a great video for you because I just want to kind of explain what's happening in each section rather than just play through and kind of have you guess what's happening. I want to actually instruct those out there that are interested in learning more about production. So with the guitar section, a lot of different folks will try to layer this particular track section for each individual element, but I decided to make it, you know, nice and easy for everyone to kind of understand the elements as they form together. So we have our guitar and bass line that comes up first. Let's look at our guitar pattern. I'm using the Kontakt VST. I'm getting a great acoustic guitar, and basically I'm just strumming up these notes here. So if we just go to our pattern selection, okay, so I use the velocity to imitate a guitar player as best I can. I'm not a guitarist, but I understand the elements that go into making a guitar sound. And that other melodic line that we hear is our bass. So we just go to our bass here. So since the bass is a little bit more has a little bit more reverb, it has the ability to have longer sustaining notes, whereas with the guitar we have to strum, as we can see here, through our ghost notes. I put the guitar and bass in one particular pattern because it was just easier to manage and actually show you side by side the elements that make this guitar riff for this song. So this is our riff. It doesn't change much throughout the song. It stays pretty much in the same consistent sound that you hear. Now, in the original mix, you hear a lot of variations, but here I try to keep it very simple so everyone out there can kind of break apart this FLP and take a look at what's actually happening. So now we have our percussion pretty standard right here. Alright, so that's that. And then we layer our clap and our snare. And again, this is just an educational tool, not an actual piece that will go into production. This is just for understanding the elements that go into making this particular kind of song. Let that snare roll a little bit, chopped it up. And then we add a little bit of the variations of the hi-hats right here, as you can listen to it. Okay, that's our snare, but our snap that we hear at the beginning of the song. Just a regular standard two finger snapping. Now, the synth, I decided to use the Trap Boom VST, which is listed inside of this tutorial. It's pretty interesting. I like it, it's very bold and aggressive. With this mix, I wanted to have a little bit more of an edge since I don't have a vocalist in this piece. I'm missing vocals. I wanted to make something that compensates for that. Little rapid fire effect with the snare. Now, our variation with the synth pad. I did a second variation as well. A few variations, but essentially a bit of a variation here. I have my D. I'm playing part of the D major, D or B minor, and F sharp minor chords here. So I'm just playing the third interval basically in D to F sharp. I'm playing 1 to 3 right here in terms of the chord progression. Give a little bit of a variation to make it a little more dynamic sound. So that's our synth pads. And then when I use the Marimba Bell from again the Trap Boom VST, which is really, I think, essential for any kind of hip hop production or R&B or some of the new wave rock, rap, fusion, trap. So here we go for the melody. The full chorus basically, and then we have the other variation where you're just playing only a couple of bars of music for it. That's more along the pre-chorus. So if we go back to our main playlist here, right here at starting at 45 seconds in, we have our first part of our melody. Or the main part of the main hook. This particular object right here, it's just a automation clip And towards the end, the shoyu gets that this is low pass filter, low pass triangle filter that you would get through using the Fruity Love filter. Create that underwater effect. And then we have our master volume automation clip. So there's a lot of back and forth between the sound basically fading in and fading out in the original track, which is really clever. It builds up a lot of tension. And what we have here is dips down. So that was a very brief overview on how Hot Girl Bummer was created. Again, educational purposes, FLP is included. If you have FL Studio 12, it may not work, so you'll probably need a more recent edition of FL Studio 20. That's what I'm running right now. And again, the VSTs that are attached in this particular piece, you just have to order them from their particular sites, and they're having a pretty good discount. So I would take advantage of that. This is Living Force. Thanks again.